power of jealousy, the power of anger, the power of evil will work in our lives. We should not get disturbed or surprised or pained that the evil is at work in us. We need to recognize it, we need to handle it, and we need to cast it away to get back to our equilibrium, to get back to our life of God. That is very, very important. We need to recognize it. But God doesn't leave when the evil is at work in us. Equally, God, what will He do? He will begin to operate with His supernatural presence. Though we are on this earth, God will allow the heavenly power to be active while you are living on this earth. That you cannot handle the earthly attack of the enemy, earthly problems that you have with the earthly equipments, with the earthly answers. That's what we read in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 3 to 5. It is true that we are on this earth, but we cannot handle the forces of this evil that is at work on this earth with the earthly vessels, with the earthly instruments. So God supplies the supernatural, or God supplies the heavenly power to handle the earthly problems. So you and I have to receive the heaven, how the enemy attacks our thoughts, and how we have to wear the helmet of salvation to protect us from the evil thoughts that come to us. How to protect? Yes. So the enemy will be attacking us. The enemy will attack us. But then, on the other hand, God will supply His supernatural power, that with His power, with His instruments, we handle the attack of the enemy on this earth. We cannot overcome the attack of the enemy on this earth with what we receive from this earth. So we need from the heavenly. That's why what Jesus does, what God does to Joseph, we read in Genesis chapter 37, verse 5, God gave to Joseph a dream. When the enemy attacks us, God gives us the vision. That's what God gave it to Joseph. And he saw the visions that his sheep in the field, they cut and make into sheaves, no? And his sheep stands up and all the other sheaves are bowing. He is going to be one day someone chosen by God for a purpose, for a mission. He knew it. Once that vision caught hold of him, he could be able to put everything in place. Today, the tragedy in the church is everyone's minds are busy with only one, that I want to become somebody. You don't need to become somebody. Allow the vision of God to rule you, then you will live. But to replace the vision, the enemy will bring, you should become a priest, you should become somebody, you should do this. That's all your goal. A small goal. When God has kept up a big goal, He will replace the big goal with a small goal. And you will be busy only with that. When will I become? When will I become? When will I become? That's all my life. After becoming priest, what will you do? What will you do? But God says, develop your vision. What is the vision? You are born somewhere. You are grown somewhere. God has brought you for a purpose. There he has given you a vision, a mission. The more you deeper go into that vision and mission, you begin to bloom. You are in your father's family. God brought you out of them. What is the vision? Why did God bring you out of that? Yes. And the enemy will continue his work 24 hours in our sleeps. So you also need to work 24 hours. 24 hours you have to be in touch with heavenly power to destroy the earthly evil spirits. Many of them, the moment they see the satanic attacks, they forget to get connected with that. With the earthly power, they try to attack the earthly evil elements and they can't proceed. Some even get failed. But Joseph moved with the power of God. The brothers saw, they felt jealousy. They pulled away his clothes. They wanted to kill him. But nothing could work. When you move with the spiritual power, presence of God, it will look as though it is an end. But the moment you reach there, you realize it is not an end. It is only a bend. God takes you in a different direction. And then you move on. So they wanted to kill. Last minute, God raised up Reuben. Reuben said, No. What will daddy? I am the eldest fellow. God may ask me. He thought God put into Reuben's mind. He said, No. Let me not kill our brother. To make them happy. We'll put him into the deep pit. Let him. That when all the brothers go away, I can save him. That's what he thought. God will prepare a way for you. When you stand with God, God himself will prepare a way for you. When the boy was inside, God sent the Ishmaelites who bought that boy and sold that boy to a man who was working with the emperor Pharaoh. Tomorrow Joseph is to go to the emperor's house and become an assistant to the emperor. That is taking place so many years. Joseph did not know. So the Potiphar, in whose house he was sold, he used to talk about his boss. He used to make the things in his house as he has learned in the palace. So he is already trained. He did not know for what purpose he is trained. His mind is saying, what stupid you are. You have lost your mother. When you are born, your mother died. And your father loved you. And now you are pulled away from your father. And now you are pulled away from your home. Now you are pulled away even from your language. You are sold to different place. You are went through lot all kinds of painful experience. And even where they are sold, so much of temptation. The lady in that house is mad after him. One after another problems. The enemy will be attacking you one by one. He will never leave you because he knows that you are special. He knows that you are meant, you are God's work is on you. You are a person when problem comes, you don't run around the world, you run to God. He knows your root. He knows you have a purpose. He knows through you something beautiful for God is going to take place. Only the trees which has the fruits get the stones. So when things go wrong, don't get upset. Don't get upset. That's why Jesus said in John's Gospel, chapter 16, verse 20, when you go through the things of this earth, you will begin to weep. Unable to bear the struggle of life, you will be crying. And the people who know it, They are supposed to stand by you. Your brothers, your sisters, your neighbors, your friends. Oh, you are going through this struggle. Oh, your children are going through the struggle. Instead of standing by you, they will be laughing at you. Jesus said, you will be going through pain and crying, and the world will laugh at you. But that is not the end. But the God who is at work in you, he will also, when the evil is working 24 hours, God is also working 24 hours with you. So what will God do? He will turn your sadness into joy. You will be weeping and the world will be laughing, but I will turn your sadness, your tears into joy.